Hello everyone, my name is Khalid Elgiaba and we are the reporter for 5.1 entitled Doing Historical Research Online together with Yeasha Ochoa. In this lesson, magkakaroon kami ng discussion about some internet, cyberspace, mga search engines na kadalasan nating ginagamit, digital libraries, online archives, and also a government website in the Philippines.
So good morning everyone, my name is Yeasha Ochoa and for today's video, we are going to discuss about doing historical research online. So first, let us start with the first tool that any student use nowadays to do research, or specifically the internet. So the internet has increasingly become the primary means by which anyone would find any information that they need. So alam naman natin na sa panahon ngayon is naging part na rin ng buhay natin ang pagsaserve sa internet. Lalong-lalo na malaking tulong ito sa atin bilang isang estudyante. Lalo-lalo na kapag may mga task tayo, activities, schoolworks na kailangang tapusin is pumupunta tayo sa internet upang humanap ng sources, ng additional knowledge regarding the topic na gagawin natin. And also sa ating pang-araw-araw na gawain, nakakatulong din ito kapag may hindi tayong alam na gusto nating gawin, pumupunta tayo sa internet para maghanap ng process or para tulungan tayo upang malaman ang about dun sa bagay na yun. So because of single click, students are able to access tons and tons of available information, so much information in fact that it would be easy to get lost in all the data available. So sa sobrang daming laman ng internet, sa sobrang daming bagay na pwede mong hanapin sa internet is hindi madali lang tayong ma-distract about the advertisement pop-ups na biglang sumusulpot sa bawat website sa pinupunta natin. Minsan naman is nagugulat na lang tayo, napupunta na tayo sa another website instead of mag-focus tayo dun sa isang website na specifically na nire-research natin. For example, nito is gumagawa tayo ng research, ng activities, and then gulat na lang tayo is nag-serve na pala tayo sa TikTok, sa Facebook. So further, know what is internet? Have you ever wondered who invented internet and when was it invented? So, internet is a vast network that connects all the computers all around the world and provides information, variety of information and communication facilities such as Facebook, WhatsApp, Messenger, Instagram, TikToks, and many, many more. So, who invented internet? The internet and its modern form has changed over the years and it's relatively new. This means na ang internet daw ay patuloy na nagbabago to its best version at patuloy na nag-upgrade at hindi lang siya limited sa kung ano meron lang siya. So, a new computer or a new communications protocol was established during 1983, and it is called as the Transfer Control Protocol or Internet Protocol or yung TCP/IP. And this allowed different kinds of computers on different networks to talk to each other. So, because of this TCP/IP, is mas napadali yung pagkakaroon ng communication between two computers. So, instead of ipadala manually yung data to other computer, ang TCP/IP is pinadali niya ang work ng ARPANET na pinalitan ito. So, ang ARPANET and the Defense Data Network officially changed to the TCP/IP standard on January 1 of 1983, hence the birth of the internet. So, after nito mapalitan, all networks could be connected by universal language. So, after nito napalitan from the ARPANET to TCP/IP, is mas madali yung communication from two computers. So, a quick trivia about ARPANET. Yung ARPANET is the Advanced Research Project Agency Network. So, ito yung gamit noon before the TCP/IP. And was established on 1969, which is ang main purpose niya lang ng our PANET is for academic and research only. So hindi talaga siya compatible or hindi talaga siya for communication. Para lang siya mag-score ng data. So nung pinalitan ng CCPIP ang ARPANET is mas naging better yung way of communication ng internet. Kaya instead of yung 1969 ang official date of inventory or invention ng internet is ginawa siyang January of 1983 kasi nga mas nagpaganda, mas nag-upgrade ang function ng internet. So sino nga ba ang naka-invento ng internet? Vinton Cerf and Robert Kahn or Vint Cerf and Bob Kahn invented internet. Or this is the one who designed the software code that is used to transmit data over the internet. So itong na-invent nila nito, ito na yung TCP/IP or yung Transfer Control Protocol or Internet Protocol. So moving on. So next is cyberspace. So what is cyberspace? Ano nga ba ang cyberspace? Cyberspace is a virtual or online world of computer networks and especially the internet used to facilitate online communication. So ano nga ba ang purpose ng cyberspace? Cyberspace allows users to share information, interact, swap ideas, play games, engage in discussions or social forums, conduct business, and many other activities. So, the term cyberspace was first used by the American-Canadian author William Gibson in 1982 in his book, Neuromancer. So, ang cyberspace ay created, is a word created by an author named William Gibson in his book entitled Neuromancer. So, this book is a science fiction novel. So, when Gibson created the word or mentioned the word in his book, he described cyberspace as the creation of a computer network in a world filled with artificial intelligent beings. So ano nga ba ang cyberspace? So, ang cyberspace ay isang platform or a virtual world whereas you can communicate with other people. Example nito is Messenger, WhatsApp, Omegel. Basta kung anong platform ang pwede ka makipag-communicate, makipag-usap sa ibang tao is considered as cyberspace. So, cyberspace is a great source of research or is a great resource for research if you know how to properly use it. Remember that just because information is available does not mean you should just get it and use it right away. Appropriating something such as an idea as yours is considered plagiarism. So, not because madami tayong mahanap na information sa cyberspace, sa internet, is gagamitin na lang natin ito without properly giving credits to the author or the original creator of the informations that you will be using. Kasi kapag ginamit mo ito at inako ang credits to that work, is pwede kang makasuhan ng plagiarism. So, which you need to treat anything you find online as a source and use the same historical methods you have learned to analyze the data you get online. So, kapag kukuha tayo ng information from the internet, you need to citations sa mga author or sa mga creator ng works na kinukuha natin dito para maiwasan natin yung plagiarism na krimen na tinatawag. So, one of the skills that will get us far in doing historical research online and is very vital sa paghahanap ng sources online is first is knowing where to look and how to look. Ito yung dalawang skills na kailangan natin tandaan sa paghahanap ng sources online. Using search engine websites such as Yahoo or Yahoo.com or Google or Google.com could lead you to a lot of sources with the right search strings. So, bago natin talakayin kung ano ang search strings, alamin muna natin kung ano yung search engines. So, ang search engine is a web-based tool that enables users to locate information in World Wide Web. So, ito yung nakikita natin sa taas na kung saan nilalagyan natin ng websites na hahanapin natin. Halimbawa, ito yung itatype natin dito yung google.com, yahoo.com, facebook.com. Ito yung kung saan na hahanap natin ang link address. So yun. So before we dig into Yahoo and Google, let us define muna ano ang search string. So a search string is a combination of words that you use to come up with relevant results and lead you to what you're looking for. The more refined your search string is, the more definite and refined the results will be. So ang search string ay ang combination ng words na hinahanap or nilalagay natin sa search engine para mahanap ang sources sa topic natin. So, itong words na to is mga words na related sa topic natin. The more na mas nakaka-relate yung words na yun sa hinahanap nating topic, the more na mas defined and the more na mas accurate yung sources na nahanap natin sa internet. So, ano nga ba ang Yahoo? Yahoo is an internet portal that incorporates a search engine and a directory of World Wide Web or WWW sites organized in a hierarchy of topic categories. So, ang Yahoo is para lang din siyang Google saan makakahanap tayo ng or makakapag-communicate tayo to other people or makakapag-communicate tayo ng emails and also makakahanap din tayo or ma-access din natin ng iba't ibang sites just like you can. So, who is the founder of Yahoo and when was it founded? So, the founder of Yahoo are Jerry Yang and David Filo. It was founded on January of 1994 and it is now 28 years old. So, before Google, meron tayo ng Yahoo and na-access natin ng iba't ibang sites and informations online. Ito na yung most common na ginagamit natin na before is Yahoo. So, according to the rapidapi.com, Google is the most popular search engine covering over 90% of the worldwide market with outstanding features. So, yun nga, sa panahon natin ngayon, mas ginagamit na natin ngayon ang Google compared sa Yahoo. So, Google was founded on September 4, 1998 and now 24 years old. So, sumunod lang siya sa Yahoo after 4 years. It's Yahoo is 22 years old now. And it was founded by Larry and Sergey Brin. Google also provides its own customized platform for scholarly research called Google Scholar. Or, trusted ang paggamit ng Google Scholar compare sa ordinary Google lang na sa paghahanap ng sources since ang Google Scholar is dedicated lang siya for academics purposes for articles na maaaring makatulong sa atin. And it could be a good starting point in building your research by providing you an overview of existing published materials for your topic. So yun nga, since ang Google Scholar is nag-focus siya sa mga research articles na kailangan or na pwede nating gamitin sa paghahanap or sa paggawa ng research natin. And other than Google Scholar, meron din Google Books or yung World Wide Web .com. So, this also provides sources for scanned books where you may be able to read some chapters for free, and this could be useful if you want to know if a certain book would be useful to your research before going to physical library to load the book or photocopy pages of it. So, ang Google Books ay merong 10 million free books na pwede natin i-download at basahin offline. Ang Google Books din ay pwede makatulong sa atin to give overview sa if we have the specific book na gusto natin bilhin, if minsan available siya sa Google Book at pwede natin siyang i-check if ano ang content nito o if gusto natin ang overview sa content nito. So, sometimes a simple search online is all you need to find the data you need. The most often, one of the first results that will come out to be pages from Wikipedia. So, ano nga ba ang Wikipedia? Ang Wikipedia ay isang free, open content online encyclopedia created through the users known as Wikipedians. And anyone registered on the site can create an article for publication registration. It's not required to edit articles. And in 2017, it has 40 million articles. Wikipedia ay isang one of the biggest open source encyclopedia in the whole cyber space. So, meaning, open space encyclopedia, anyone can edit kung ano ang content ng Wikipedia, kung anong mga informations na nakalagay dito. So, since ang Wikipedia ay isang open source encyclopedia, this means na ang informations nito ay sometimes unreliable since na-edit. Kaya nitong ma-edit and mabago yung content ng Wikipedia ng kahit na 6 months. Ikaw, ako, pwedeng mag-contribute ng edit ng mga article nito. So, nonetheless, Wikipedia provides a useful launchpad to sources that you may use for research. Sometimes, may mga informations na naman talaga na useful from this website. And when you read from Wikipedia, look at the link citations in the articles, which could lead you to a source you may use for your own research. So, sa baba ng mga articles or ng mga information sa Wikipedia, makikita natin yung mga references or citations na pinagkuhanan ng mga information sa ito, which is pwedeng mas reliable siya compare sa Wikipedia since ito yung mga sources na pinagkuhanan from Wikipedia. However, we need to exercise caution in using this site. And as a practice, use Wikipedia to gain a general overview of what you need so that you may be guided in looking for credible and reliable sources that you need for your research. So, since hindi masasabing very reliable ang site na ito na pagkukuhanan ng information, kailangan natin maging maingat sa mga information na kukunin natin sa website na ito. And also, ang Wikipedia ay maaaring magbigay sa atin ng guidance papunta or para mahanap natin ang mga possible or credible sources na maaaring maging reliable sa mga informations na need natin.
So for the continuation of our report, there are websites that you may use to legally download scanned copies of books and other materials for free, especially those books with expired copyrights and are in public domain. Project Gutenberg or www.gutenberg.org is the oldest digital library in the world, founded in 1971. So may mga websites din na pwede nating downloadan ng mga legal scanned copies ng books, pati yung mga expired books na pwede nating gamitin for our historical research. It has more than 50,000 items in its collection, which include many works concerning the Philippines, such as Doctrina Christiana, the first published book in the Philippines, the published travelogues of foreigners who visited the Philippines, such as Jagor, Decomin, Virtue, Foreman, and Worcester, Austin Quake's biography of Rizal, and all volumes of Blair and Robertson's The Philippine Islands from 1493 to 1898. So, may mga Philippine books rin doon na mahanap natin sa Project Gutenberg, like yung mga travelogues, Doctrina Christiana, yung biography ni Rizal by Austin Quake, and tsaka yung The Philippine Islands. So, as I've searched from that website, nahanap ko yung mga ibang books by the travelogues and others. What is Doctrina Christiana? Doctrina Christiana was written in 1593 by Fray Juan de Plasencia or Juan de Plasencia. It is an early book on the catechism of the Catholic Church, and it is believed as one of the earliest printed books in the Philippines. So, yung Doctrina Christiana is pinaniniwalaang first published book in the Philippines as mentioned in the book. And the Doctrina Christiana, it was more about on church. The title means the teachings of Christianity, and thus the primary goal of the book was to propagate Christian teaching across the Philippine archipelago. So yung mission ng Doctrina Christiana ay para ipalaganap yung Christianity sa sulok ng Pilipinas. And yung title niya, it means the teachings of Christianity. So, which is tinuturo talaga yung Christianity sa Pilipinas. The book consists of 38 levels and 74 pages of text in Spanish and later on translated to Tagalog in its original Tagalog baybayin. So, yung first language ng Doctrina Christiana is Spanish, and later on na translate na ito ng Tagalog as baybayin, which is the first form of the alphabet in the Philippines. The next book from Project Gutenberg is Raisin in den Philippinen by Fedor Jagor, and was written in German language. The book was published on 1873, and the title means Journey in the Philippines. So yung Raisin in den Philippinen ay sinulat ni Fedor Jagor, which is another travelogue mentioned from the book. It was published on 1873. So yung Raisin in den Philippinen ay nangangahulugang Journey in the Philippines. This is about Jagor's journey in the Philippines during the 1859 and 1860. So who is Fedor Jagor? Fedor Jagor is an ethnologist, naturalist, and explorer who traveled throughout Asia in the second half of the 19th century. So si Fedor Jagor is a natural explorer siya, which is tina-travel niya yung Asia around 19th century. Another book is The Former Philippines Through Foreign Eyes. It was written by the following travelogues. Following travelers, which are Thomas de Comin, Fedor Jagor, Rudolf Ludwig Carl Virchow or Virchow, and Carl Charles Wilkes. The content of this book was about describing on how the Philippine time was different on other country, like difference of the time from European, and also about Magellan's mistake in reckoning and many more. So yung The Former Philippines Through Foreign Eyes is dinidescribe dito yung difference of the Philippines from another country, like yung pagkakaiba ng time from European and the Philippines. And also, na-state rin dito about yung wrong calculation of Magellan during his travels around the Philippines and many more. Another one is the Philippine Islands was written by foreman John FRGS. The content of this book was about the structure of the Philippines, including political, geographical, ethnographical, social and commercial history of the Philippine archipelago, and embracing the whole period of Spanish rule. So yung Philippine Islands naman ay dinedescribe dito yung structure ng Philippines, like political, social, yung history ng Philippine archipelago, and also about the Spanish rule in the Philippines. Another book that we can find in the Project Gutenberg is The Philippines, Past and Present, that was written by Dincy Worcester, which is one of the travelers mentioned from the book. And The Philippines, Past and Present has two volumes found from that website. The Lineage, Life and Labors of Jose Rizal, Philippine Patriot, was written by Austin Craig and available in English language. So ito na yung biography of Rizal that was written by Austin Craig. The content of this book was all about the ancestors and things that Rizal did. So yung Lineage, Life and Labors of Rizal, The Philippine Patriot, was all about sa buhay ni Rizal, and also yung biography, like ancestors and yung mga ginawa ni Rizal. So who is Austin Craig? Austin Craig is an American historian born in Edithon, New York. So isa siya sa mga pinakaunang biographers na gumawa about sa pamumuhay ni Jose Rizal. The last one that we can find in the Project Gutenberg that is about the Philippines is The Philippine Islands from 1493 to 1898. It was written by Emma Helen Blair and James Alexander Robertson. Minsan, it is referred to Blair and Robertson's The Philippine Islands because kilala sila sa mga one of the prominent authors. It consists of 55 volumes, and the content was about the Philippine historical documents, like mga exploration about the early navigations, yung description nila about sa islands of the Philippines at saka yung mga tao dito, and the history and records of Catholic missions, which is yung kung paano ba nabuo yung mga Catholic mass sa Philippines, and also the political, economics, and commercial, tsaka yung religious condition ng Philippines sa iba't ibang islands, and also about sa earliest relations with European nation from the earliest 19th century. So moving on, another online archive you may use is Internet Archive or www.archive.org, an online library that originally sought to archive web history, but grew later on to provide digital versions of other works. So another online archive that we can use for our historical research is Internet Archive, which is online library siya that more on about that is sought to archive web history. So yung first is mayroon mga digital scanned copies of books lang ang meron dito, but later on lumapalaki ng palaki na yung website at may mga iba't ibang version na ng works, like archive, like the archive contains 279 billion web pages, 11 million books and texts, 4 million audio recordings, 3 million videos, 1 million images, and 100,000 software programs. So yung Internet Archive ay from scanned copies of books ay mayroon na itong mga books web pages, recordings, videos, images, tsaka mga software programs. So, the Philippine government websites or www.gov.ph are starting to be enriched with sources that may be used for historical research, especially on laws and other government issuance that may be useful when doing topics of a more contemporary period. So yung Philippine government website ay palaki na ng palaki yung mga sources na pwede nating gamitin for historical research, especially kung involved siya sa mga laws, constitutions, agrarian reform. And then, websites of newspapers, magazines, broadcasting, stations, and other media outlets usually keep an archive of their articles from a particular date. So yung mga website, yung website na yun ay may mga newspaper din, magazines, tsaka yung mga other media outlets na kinikip nila for archives. For other issues, you may have to find copies, either digitized or physical copies in the library. So, yung mga older issues naman, like yung mga older archives or older documents, ay mahahanap natin siya sa copies from the library, either digitized or physical copies. And now for our summarization of our report, historical research studies the meaning of past events in an attempt to interpret the facts and explain the cause of events and their effect in the present events. So yung historical research ay nag-study about past events, kung ano yung cause niya, ini-interpret natin siya at saka ini-explain kung ano yung cause ng events na yun and ano yung magiging epekto niya sa present events. Ano yung importance ng historical research online? May mga advantages tayo in searching online, like in just one click, nagkakaroon tayo ng results of lots of information about history. So, anytime and anywhere, pwede natin siyang gamitin by just connecting to the internet, kahit sa bahay tayo. And we don't need to get dressed to go to physical libraries. May mga tendencies na hindi tayo nakakapunta sa physical libraries, so it is better to do historical research online na lang. That is the reason kung bakit in-explain namin yung mga search engines, online libraries, and yung internet archive at saka yung Philippine government website para alam natin kung saan tayo pupunta or magsesearch in online kapag may mga historical research tayo. But it doesn't mean na hindi na importante ang physical libraries and physical archives. Importante din ito, but then may mga tendencies din na hindi tayo nakakapunta sa physical libraries and physical archives for some reasons. And also may mga tendency rin na hindi tayo nakaka-online for lust of connections. So, dapat tayong pumunta sa mga physical libraries for historical research. And that's all for our video report. Thank you for listening and watching.